Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you about statistical imaging. Statistical neoplasm, germ cell versus non-germ cell tumor. Germ cell tumor is around 2/3 of pediatric tumor. Non-germ cell tumor is around 1/3 of pediatric tumor. Lymphoma and leukemia are also involved in this. Most common signs and symptoms: asymptomatic, endless, testicles, mild discomfort or pain in abdomen, groin or testicle, perceived scrotal heaviness. Other signs and symptoms: just assume 90% have increased alpha fetoprotein used as tumor marker. Choroidal carcinoma, most have increased beta HCG. Diagnosis is usually due to results of hematogenous metastasis. Certain cell tumor, endless mass in infant, may have gynecomastia. Lytic cell tumor, boy age around 5 to 10 years, may elaborate testosterone or have increased estrogen level, leading to precocious puberty and gynecomastia. Juvenile granulosa cell tumor, most frequent congenital testicular neoplasm. Demography represent 1 to 2% of childhood solid tumor. Around 1 per 100,000 boys. Most common malignancy in post-pubertal young men. 10% are associated with cryptorchidism. If orchiopexia occur before puberty, relative risk is 2 times that of general population. If orchiopexia after puberty, relative risk is 5 times that of general population. Increased risk in patients with microlithiasis. Demography again, 2 age peak, first 2 years of life and late adolescence. More pre-pubertal mass are benign, the abdomen, the more short, your sacs are second most common tumor. Your sac most common tumor, germ cell tumor. The abdomen increasingly reported as most common pre-pubertal tumor, most present in first years of life. Prognosis depend on age rather than presence of major or immature histological feature. Most post-pubertal mass are malignant. Embryonal carcinoma and MGCT are most common. Embryonal carcinoma very rare prior to puberty. Seminoma is semi-rare prior to puberty, usually men. Imaging intratesticular mass of variable leukocyticity and vascularity vary widely in size from imperceptible to testes and replacing. Teratoma characteristically have extremely complex appearance with cystic area, calcification, solid component, and punched it on linear equation can epidermoid through this non neoplasm appear solid tagadoid or onion skin from lamination of keratinizing stratified squamous epithelium. Regress GCT may appear as architectural distortion with ill-defined microcalcification. Sacral stromal tumor are often small and well-defined. Ultrasound of a juvenile granulosa cell tumor in a newborn with firm testis enlargement, so a heterogeneous mass replacing the testis. There are numerous hypoechoic poses. Separated by seam, separate a classic afferent of this rare tumor. Ultrasound show a large left-sized testicular teratomen in a 15-year-old with 12 months of painless scrotal swelling. The 8-centimeter partial cystic mass is quite heterogeneous and complex, as is typical of this common pediatric testicular tumor. Note right side microvigasis. Ultrasound so asymmetric enlarge of the left testis due to leukemic infiltration. Whole lot of blood ultrasound, so mark asymmetric hyperemia of left testis compared to the normal right side, a common finding in leukemic infiltration. Still I'm in a teenager in a high hematoma, so two incident hypointense mass in the left testis. Note the normal homogeneously hyperintense apparent of the right testis. Seminoma was found at biopsy. Ultrasound showed a fairly small, ill-defined intratestical mass with extensive calcification, causing posterior acoustic shadowing. No other lesion was seen in either testis. Arachidectomy was performed, and this mass was confirmed as an embryonal carcinoma. Treatment standard of care, arachidectomy, testis-sparing enucleation may be performed in newborn and pre-puberty boy without increased alpha fetoglobulin. Josephine and teratoma is puberal boy, and pre-puberty boy need to further treatment beyond arachidectomy. Thank you.